I am so pleased to be here with Chance Beeler today in the Eden Identity video series. We are talking with faculty and students and alumni about what they're doing, about how they've gotten here and how Eden may have shaped them, and about vocation. And it happens that you, Chance, are both an alum and a current DMEN student. Tell us a little bit about what you're up to these days.
So I graduated from Eden in 2015. Immediately after graduation, I started training as a chaplain at SLU. I went through an internship in CPE and then stayed for a residency. And it's been a journey. Originally, I thought I'd go get as much pastoral care training as I could to become a pastor. And I found that my call to become a chaplain became loud and clear through that residency and the time I spent at SLU. My training through the CPE program and through Eden really has helped me to grow into this position. Prior to being at Eden, I was a leader. By trade, I worked in human resources and management, and was, I had different roles in training, and all those married with my training that I had at Eden, and the discernment I got from that experience and the community there has helped me to grow into what I am doing now. And especially during this COVID-19 time, I've been able to kind of step up and use my experience as a crisis leader. I was the disaster captain in my previous job for our organization. I would work with folks in time of disaster. So now that we're in the midst of a pandemic, it feels very similar.
That is really vital ministry, and how you've been able to weave together your past experience and your training and the current context.
As a doctoral student, I was in search of a topic come the beginning of this year, and have found my topic to be pastoral care in the midst of pandemic. Seeing that the awareness of chaplaincy has really picked up during the COVID-19 pandemic times, in that folks recognize that we are in the field, we're essential workers, and that we are going in and seeing the patients that especially during that time when they could not have visitors, we were linking families and patients and their clergy in different ways. You know, our focus has shifted a little bit more to taking care of our staff, staff being our the nurses and doctors, the environmental workers, the food workers, everyone who's an essential worker in a hospital. We're all experiencing a similar thing, you know, which is, hey, we're out here in the midst of it every day. And, you know, making sure people are taking care of themselves and looking at their spiritual life and what is important to them and what gives them life. And are they taking time away? And am I taking the time away that I need to make sure that I'm able to take care of my folks? I find that as a chaplain, you know, before COVID-19, it was a question of how do we show who we are? And the question was always, what do you do as a chaplain? And now we're saying, this is what we do as a chaplain, and what else can we do? And how can we continue to support our patients and their families and staff and the local clergy during this time of pandemic?
And it sounds like in a lot of ways that you're reimagining what chaplaincy is.
And I think that we're reimagining it in a way that continues to bring life. And we really are thinking about what is important to us, and what do we miss, and how can we bring some of that back while at the same time being careful. The little things are starting to become more extraordinary. We celebrate the fact that, you know, we've gone this long without someone, you know, getting sick, or, you know, we were able to come up with a new idea of how to do blessing of the hands. That's a very big process that we do that requires you touch people's hands, but how can we do that without touching hands? And how do we continue to be who we are while being different? And I think that we really can I help people identify when they need to name something that's going on in their own concerns, to help them find hope, or help them find that, hey, there's something in this situation to celebrate, such as our community coming around the hospital and really giving us support in the midst of the peak of our preparation for COVID-19. We were called superheroes. The fact that our community has come around us at this time, now we're also trying to make sure that we're giving them the support that they gave us and saying thank you and keeping that going. So it's a rich time for us in the healthcare system, you know, and to be able to look at each day as a new opportunity to do our ministry in a new way.
When you started out, you talked about, you thought you were going to go into pastoral ministry in a local congregation, and the place of that ministry switched along the way. Do you see any connection with local congregations? And
so, yes, I think in a lot of ways, I still interact with a lot of folks in the community, and some of those community members are my classmates, you know, and we talk all the time. We have a different perspective on this crisis, but we're all living through it. We really value the support of our local clergy. We know that when their church member comes in the hospital, that when they enter the room, it has a different feeling than when I enter the room. Because I am not their pastor. And when their pastor comes in, it's different, you know, and that if they need support, that's where we come in. We want to support the pastor when they come in. Ultimately, I see this as one and the same, yet we express it differently. I am pastoral. I am creative. I am Eden.